Julio Iglesias was the first singer to introduce the world to Latino rhythm, and the world has shown its appreciation by making him an international superstar. Most artists would be delighted to receive one gold or platinum album. Julio has won an incredible 2,600. He is the most popular recording artist in the world and sings in 8 languages. Julio does not rest on his success. He is a tireless perfectionist who crafts each song until it satisfies his ear. In 2004, Julio Iglesias released his 77th album, Divorcio, and he has no intentions of slowing down. He continues to warm our hearts with stories of romance and personal relationships. Although Julio is originally from Spain, when he is able to get away from touring and recording, he comes here to his second home in the Dominican Republic. This paradise in the Caribbean is only 2 hours from the United States, and it provides a quiet refuge for Julio and his family.
I am so excited to be here on the beautiful island of Dominican Republic. We are in the home of the world's most famous Latino singer, Julio Iglesias. His love songs are absolutely my favorite. Over his long and illustrious career of 35 years, he has sold over 250 million albums.
This legendary star has invited us to his Caribbean home in the Dominican Republic, where we got an intimate look at his life.
Julio, I have to start the conversation by asking you about your newest album, Divorcio.
Now you're speaking good Spanish. Not easy to say
divorcio. It's very difficult to say, especially there are so many versions of Spanish, right? Divorcio. Divorcio.
Divorcio.
Yes.
You know what that means?
Yes, divorce. But why do you choose such a funny name for a group of love songs?
Well, there is a song in the album called Divorcio, which is a song very funny. It talks about a couple, and they make love in the morning. In the afternoon, at night they said we're going to divorce next morning. They make love at night. The next day they divorce, and at night they also make love. This is a class of divorce, Cuban style.
Cuban.
Cuban style, which means that they take it together anyway. It's a nice divorce. It's not a bad one.
But what I don't understand is you seem to have everything already, right, in your life, and you certainly don't need to make a new album to make money. You have everything.
No.
Why do you keep working so hard? Why do you keep having new albums?
Because, first, I don't think I have another thing to do in my life than to sing anymore. It's too late to get back to something else. I think I was born to be a singer. I didn't know before, but now I know I'm a singer. And it's a way to tell the people that I'm alive, that I want them, that I love them, then I want to be loved, in a way, you know? And that's why we are here together.
You really are the first Latino singer that really make so famous worldwide. What do you think are the reasons for your success? Can you try to analyze?
When they ask me that question, I don't want to be incorrect or non-modest, but the true story is the culture of the music is not the beginning of my career. I believe that the culture of the music, the cha-cha, the tango, the guaracha, the mambos, the salsas, the sons, the merengues, all that music combined what is the culture of the Latino people. I was an exponent in a good time because the media was much more in communications with the music. You know, for me, they were incredible artists, Latino artists. Gardel, Gaticas, Negretes, great, great artists. I was lucky because I came to America and United States in the beginning of a generation of exposition of music in the early 80s.
I want all of you, all of you.
all you're giving, let me give you all of me.
You once said that fame is a gift from God. How so, you think? You work so hard to get to where you are.
Well, fame is a gift from a very special God. We has the faces of millions of people. And fame is not something which has makes a lot of difference between human beings. It's just a moment in life that you understand for the first time then life that millions of people give you that gift, then makes you feel in front of the others like a little better singer, or you communicate things in another way, then they like the way you do that things. But the difference are so little, then if I believe sometimes the people will know the difference, they will not understand. So it's very difficult to explain with logical what fame is about. The only thing I can say to the people is that I love when they love me. And it will be always that relation, and that love relation is like making love with million people, day by day, through the years.
Julio Iglesias is more than a recording artist. He has captured the hearts of entire countries. He maintains this international love affair by performing concerts all over the world, over 4,600 so far.
Your image in the world is that you are this sexy Latino singer, you know, charming and debonair and everything else. What do you think of that?
First, I think then is that when you put the Latino sexy together, which is like a common name, you know, say Latino has to be sexy, or whatever it is, that's a little legend of every all Latinos in general. I'm a normal man who loves life and love, of course, in all the sense of life and the world. And my perception, the perception the people has about me, I don't want to get them confused. Whatever they want to think is okay for me, because they give me so many beautiful things through my life. I cannot say anything. I don't want to hear that. No, whatever they say, whatever they want it. Because in a way, all these things that happened to me in the last 60 years is because of them.
Mm. Anything negative about crazy fans? Like people can sometimes be crazy, no?
No. Crazy. Happens many things to me in my life. Happened being sleeping and somebody down in my bed, you know, and I didn't know it was in my bed. And
Oh no.
I started to feel something in my back.
Underneath?
She was in my room, maybe waiting for me. She felt a little guilty, so they went down on the bed, and I was I started to feel in my back. And it was somebody who was in the hotel, working in the hotel, a girl, and she was a cutie, no problems.
This is funny.
Happened many things in my life, but always fun. You know, fans are very important in the life of in our lives. Fans are the people who really make us growing up as an artist. I would not survive without fans.